Punch decided it's Punch Week on OWHTV, so he wanted to help me with these monster cards. I'm Sandy Allnock, Executive Director of Operation Right Home, and I have two things to share. One is the Halloween deadline is this Saturday. Get your Halloween cards in the mail immediately. We need to get these boxes out the door so we can get the turkeys and the elves going. And we've got a lot of work to do, so your help in meeting these deadlines is really, really, really important to us. Second thing I want to share is kids' cards. The theme for last week's midweek throwdown was children's cards, and I wanted to talk about that a little bit. Children's cards should be ones that look like they're for children, but not that they're made by children. We get a lot of confusion about that. A lot of people think that if you just slap a princess sticker on something, it makes it a kid's card, and that's not necessarily true. We still need the cards to appeal to an adult sensibility because that's who's going to be choosing the cards to send to their kids. This first card I cased, not from this stamp set, somebody else had used a different one, but all of her other cards were great, and then when she got to her kids' section, she did cards like this with just random stamps all over the card, bad stamping, didn't pay attention to it like she had done with the rest of her cards. This is not what our heroes are asking for. They want something that's going to appeal to them. Now, this one is a whole lot more fun. It's got a lot simpler stamping going on. I got crazy with the coloring. You don't have to do that. I added shading around the Lawn Fawn bubble that I added to the stamp set. This whole stamp set is from Hero Arts, except for that bubble. And then I added this little bat, and I stuck him on with a tiny piece of glue dot. And now the daddy monster is looking at the little baby monster, and I think that's really cute. Now it's also got a couple layers to it. I added orange and black because if they want to use it for Halloween, they can. This one, I went again crazy with the coloring. Yeah, you know me. I gotta color like a crazy person or it's not a Sandy card. I saw these guys as little butterflies even though they're bats. And I wanted to make it look like they're kind of fluttering off together like this. And so I added a crazy background to it. You don't have to do that. It can just be a simple image there. But notice that I used layers, I used dimensional adhesive, I used some brads, some patterned paper. Just make it something that's going to appeal to adults as well. This one was so much fun. I stamped all the little Hero Arts monsters and colored them up, and then I trimmed them out and ran them through my Xyron so I could make a little scene out of them. I've added some medium green grass and dark green trees, a moon out of some textured paper on the black background, and then the huge monster Hugs is on the inside. Hugs is a love sentiment, in case you've ever wondered. And I also rubbed it really good around all the places where the Xyron was to make sure there's no sticking on the outside of the card to stick to something else. The kids who are going to get these cards are little superheroes. They go to bed every night with maybe only mom or only dad kissing them goodnight. Sometimes only grandma, because both parents are deployed. Wouldn't it be awesome if the child took this card to school? And then maybe, for one child, it'll be the first time that they have shared that their parent is fighting overseas because of this really cool card that they wanted to tell everybody about. But go put a lot of love into the cards, even the ones for kids. Your common question for the day is there a child in your life who you should send a card to today? Go make them one and make it an extra special one to let them know how much you think of them. Punch is going to continue to supervise me here. He would like you to click that like button, subscribe, favorite, and share. And we'll see you tomorrow.